2 years back and tell you exactly how the book eventually happened. It was January 13th, 2014, when as a family our life was completely wrecked. It was a casual brunch that me, my wife and my son had gone for to Taj Lands End, and it was there where we detected some abnormal symptoms in our son, and we rushed him to the hospital. There was his head pediatrician there, and the tests began. You know, there was a conversation that we had 2 weeks back. We didn't want, we were delaying a simple blood test for the hemoglobin because we didn't want our child to go through physical trauma when a needle went into his arm. And here in this hospital, there was needle after needle jabbed into his arm, and doctors trying to get to the bottom of the problem. Anyways, that nightmarish of a day ended. We went back home, and I went onto the internet to do my own research, and I typed out his symptoms, and what I was confronted with on one website really tore my heart apart. It said the dreaded C word, and below that there were a list of other diseases, and I remember going to sleep that night. Before that I prayed to God and I said that please don't let this be cancer, please don't let this be cancer. But next day, our worst fears manifested. His chest x-ray and his blood test were normal. But in his sonography, there was a tumor the size of a seasoned ball that was growing on top of his left kidney. And I remember seeing it on the sonography machine, this dark gray haze. For those of you who don't know what that's a Wilms tumor. It's a very rare case of kidney cancer that happens to a minuscule percentage of kids. Of all pediatric cancers, roughly around 2 to 3%, and he happened to be part of that unfortunate percentage of kids. If you've had someone close to you being diagnosed with this disease, you know what the next couple of weeks, months, and possibly years are like. You're hearing things like staging, pathology, chemotherapy, remission, radiation, and it was very frightening for us back then because we didn't know the staging of the cancer. And even these cancers are divided into two subgroups, which is favorable and unfavorable. God forbid a child has unfavorable, the chemotherapy does not work. But God was, I guess, very kind. In the next week after the surgery, we realized it was a favorable cancer. And we as parents and family, we fought hard for 7 months. We took him to Toronto for his treatment, chemotherapy. And through this entire phase, and this is how the book actually started, somewhere it started seeding in my mind, that there was this fear in me, and there's a fear that in most of cancer patients and parents, a fear that when the chemotherapy is being administered, you feel the job is being done and that something is fighting the disease. But what happens once that stops? Doctors and oncologists didn't give me the right answer. They didn't give me the answer I wanted to hear. They told me that, you know, take the chemotherapy, fingers crossed, it won't come back. Because there is recurrence in cancer, there is a 5-year survival rate. So I started doing my own research, and turned out some great information which was going to help us out was that roughly 90% of cancers were lifestyle related, and a small percentage of cancers were genetic, which means that we could have fought this, we can fight it. And there are a lot of things that come into play. There is, obviously, lifestyle is what, when you come to cancer, when you come to terms with why cancer happens. The air we breathe, the food we eat, the water we drink, the stress levels, all of this contributes to an abnormality in the body. And we put Ayan on a very, very good diet. He's probably the only 6-year-old who has a vegetable smoothie. I can't have it. So he really, I guess, worked his way himself to cure himself of this disease. And, you know, it's statistically, they say that roughly by 2030, there will be 4 in 5 people who will have cancer. And that's a very alarming rate for our country. That means probably everyone in this room, at some point of time, with our given diets and lifestyle, are candidates to get this disease. So I felt, once Hussein came to me and Bilal came to me and they said that, you know, you have to get this information out to people, and if it touches one life and gets the information to them, it'll be a great accomplishment. And this is not just for cancer patients, this is for people, for prevention. Because even we as a family felt that this could never happen to us. Cancer is something that happens to someone else. But I have news for you. It comes knocking on your door without a warning, and sometimes it gets very late. So I would advise everyone to go out and read this book. We have put the last three chapters, which are about what you can eat and what you can avoid to reduce your probability of getting this disease, something that oncologists will not tell you. I have nothing against them. They have saved my son's life because chemotherapy was given to him. But the fact is that food does not come into their domain. It cannot be patented. So that's why pharma companies will never say, if you have curcumin, for example, it can help you fight heart disease and cancer. So all these things have been documented in this book. So I hope everyone gets to read it. You know, first things first, when we've decided that this is going to be documented in this book, I thought it's going to be an extremely painful journey to relive all of that once again. In some ways, moments brought about you know, feelings of nostalgia, because like Bilal said, the book is not just about the episode of cancer. It's about retracing my family and how I was in college, school, my grandmother, my father, everyone in the family. But apart from that, I think it was very therapeutic. It's like counseling, you know. There are feelings that are there. You've been through them. They're painful. But the moment you talk about them or you pen them down, it just finds some kind of closure. So I think this book really, you know, when I went through reading it at one stretch, once it was done, it again was extremely therapeutic to know that the worst is behind us. And fascinating, because we as a family unit could actually get through this and we could fight this disease. And it takes me back to the first day, the hope with which we started off, where Parveen and me held back our tears because we couldn't in front of him. We had to show and we'd be this come from a place of strength and told ourselves that we're going to get through this and we're going to make sure nothing happens to our son. So it's just a feeling of accomplishment. Everyone felt that, my family, friends, everyone when they read the book.